We have approximately 300 acres of fruit trees, and whenever we do make a decision to apply a pesticide, there's six. We have six spray rigs. Well, actually seven now, counting our new one. We have seven spray rigs that will go out at one time to cover 300 acres. And usually what we're trying to do is cover it all up within 6 to 8 hours of time. Everybody puts two or three tanks on, and then we're done. With this new outfit, it's amazingly how much more finite it is. We can hook up to each individual nozzle on the sprayer and determine its output. I mean, that doesn't sound like much, but whenever you have a spray tip that's plugged or something, it shows right up on our water collected on our cylinder that there's something wrong with that nozzle, and you examine it. And you know, I feel that we should be calibrating at least every year. Every year in the spring, it should be a definite must for, you know, all fruit growers. Even brand new equipment, in one of our trials, our tractor, despite what the tax said was 2.5 miles, it wasn't going 2.5 miles an hour, despite what the tax said. Here we found out that the tires were a different size than what the manufacturer recommended at that rate. And our sprayer is the same. As long as we can keep, we know what the volume of water coming out is, you know, we're very confident with that. I would say we do have a time saving. We spend time early in the spring to making sure everything's right, and then we don't have to worry about it so much the rest of the year. As long as we each spray our own area and come out at the same time, then we can just zip right back to the fuel station, fill up with water, and away we go again, rather than having to worry about, oh, now is this nozzle right, or is this one not putting out wrong or something. I mean, we have confidence that, you know, the sprayers and tractor are working correctly.
Spray coverage. How much of your chemical water solution gets covered in the tree canopy and the fruit itself, and that would in turn lead to disease and pest prevention?
We're with our acreage, and each of us does two or three tanks. We empty out, mix up two or three times. What'll happen is if you have a plugged nozzle or what isn't working correctly, you'll extend the water that we're using, and we won't come out at our regular place that we usually do. And then, or if you're putting out too much, we'll be short as far as, you know, where our volume for everybody that comes out. So we can determine what correct amount of water for that application rate goes on, and to be sure about it and do have a peace of mind, we hook up to the new calibration machine, and it'll tell you what your sprayer's doing. There's no question about it. You know, even if you only have a few acres of trees and you only have one sprayer, you know, I'd still recommend using, you know, the new calibration machine, because you can correctly identify your volume of water you're wanting to use, and you can save a lot of money through your pesticide use.
The biggest thing we get out of these calibrations is the peace of mind, knowing that you're safe as far as your nozzle output, everything's working as it should. That way you can have that much more confidence in growing fruit.
That's what, you know, what we're all about, making the correct application, the amount of water that we're putting on per acre, per material that's recommended. And with this machine, I mean, we can really hit the nail on the head by doing that.
Hello. As a member of the agricultural community, you know the important part that your equipment plays in your success. You also know the value of proper maintenance and care for all of that equipment, especially your Air Blast sprayer. Part of those maintenance procedures is making sure your sprayer is calibrated correctly, so that it operates in a safe and cost-effective manner. Improper calibration, or even no calibration at all, can lead to applying too much or not enough material. This can be costly in terms of crop damage or expensive overruns. And that's what proper air blast sprayer calibration is all about. Protecting the investment you've made in your equipment, the inputs you purchase, and the crops you grow. However, before calibration can take place, there are a few steps you need to take in order to make the calibration process run smoothly. Let's take a look at those steps. Step one, triple rinse your sprayer tank and all the piping. This is common practice for cleaning any sprayer or pesticide container. It's important for the safety of those doing the calibration testing that there's no pesticide residue that they might be exposed to from the equipment. Step two, pressure wash the sprayer. Pay special attention to cleaning both sides of the nozzles, around the pumps and filters. Again, this should be your regular practice when cleaning equipment used in applying pesticides, and it does help with the safety of those working on the sprayer. The next couple of steps will help provide more control over the variable parts of the application process. Managing these variables will help make sure your spraying is more cost-effective. Step three, clean the individual nozzles and record orifice and whirl disk sizes. It's important to have an accurate record of what sizes these items are, or at least what they're supposed to be. It's rare that disk sizing errors by the manufacturer occur, but it can happen. Orifice and whirl disk sizes are one of the most important variables that can affect and change sprayer output. Step four, flush out the line to the pressure gauge. In addition to nozzle orifice and whirl plate sizes, line pressure is another important variable in adjusting sprayer output. Clogged lines or other imperfections can lead to incorrect pressure readings. Accurate pressure readings are essential to proper calibration. Step five, clean your filters. This includes tank filters, suction filters, final filters, and every screen behind the nozzles. This is all part of making sure that the entire system is clean and working properly. Residue clogs in nozzles and valves will alter the system's output and prevent accurate calibration. Step six, make sure all valves, diaphragms, and O-rings are in good condition and working properly. Again, remember the importance of the entire system being clean and working correctly. Residue clogs or blockages or worn-out elements will alter the sprayer output, which means your calibration or application measurements will be affected as well. Step seven, check tire pressures on both the tractor and sprayer. Low tire pressure on either vehicle can cause variations in your speed and affect material output. Step eight, make sure the tractor's tachometer is working properly. The tachometer is the only way that you, as the operator, know that the tractor and sprayer are running at the same speed every time. Step nine, fill the sprayer halfway with clean water. When determining the speed of the tractor sprayer, you'll want to find the average. A full sprayer tank will likely make the vehicles move more slowly, while less water in the tank could increase the speed. A half-full tank should be the average weight at which the tractor sprayer will operate. Step 10, it's important to have operators or mechanics that work with the tractor and sprayer combination on hand for the calibration. Everyone who operates this equipment needs to understand its proper calibration in order to oversee its cost-effective and appropriate usage. When workers know how to use and calibrate the sprayer correctly, you reduce the opportunity for costly mistakes in pesticide application. Their presence may also be helpful in answering any questions the calibration team may have about the equipment's history and usage. Step 11, have the operator's manual for your application equipment available. If problems occur during the calibration process, the manual is helpful in supplying solutions or other technical information for adjusting the tractor or sprayer's functions. It's as simple as those 11 steps. It's not a long list or a difficult one to accomplish. Doing this work ahead of time will make the calibration process go more smoothly and can add to the accuracy of the final results. After all, having your sprayer equipment working correctly is necessary for the growth and success of your crops and your business in general. Let's work together to make it happen.